everyone, it's Els here at the Elizabeth Craft Design Studio. Today I'm introducing to you a new paper flower collection. In the collection we have 10 dies and one paper pack. Let's take a closer look to the designs and some samples. So this is the floral one die set. And what we want to do with these florals is that you do whatever you want. I want you to combine the different leaves with the different flowers. That's why we call it florals, because I don't want it to be a specific flower, although of course this looks like a poppy, but here, look at that, Anita did something, so she has the poppy leaves here and another flower. So I want you to mix and match and kind of create a freedom with the flowers as well. You can make it anything you want. So this is floral one. So then we have florals two, here you are. And I made some samples with this, and look at the background paper as well. That is absolutely gorgeous, and Anita created these. So this is with the doily on the back, and this one kind of more ornate here with some swirls that I will show you in a second as well. And then as you can see, so for this one, I made it a little bit, you see this, you can say this is, looks like a hydrangea, but then I made this one, you see, so same flower, and I just put two of those flowers together. So there's four different sizes. So this is two stacked. This is just a small one here. And I love you to play with these. And here you see a little bit of the new berry branch as well. So that's that one. And then we go to florals three. That's this one. So you have like three different flowers, two leaves and the centers. And again, two totally different cards. So this one created by Anita. So she made like a circle here, put the flowers there. You can do different centers. Here I actually have a craft drop in the center. So that's this one. So this one I created myself. So these are some stems from the Planner Essentials. And then I made a background using a stencil from Ilse and Charlene from the Art Journal line. And then white soft finish with some distress ink and then the flowers. And if you can see here the difference, so what Anita did, Anita offset them, you see, so she offset the flowers and I kind of stacked them exactly on top of each other, like in the same shape. So two totally different flowers, love that. And then this is floral set number four. So you see that beautiful sample that Anita created. And we have the worn wood paper in the background. We use the squares with the rounded edges, the stitched and the regular one. And this one comes with the three flowers, two leaves, and then those buds here, or rose bottles we call it in the Netherlands. I don't know how we call it here, but you can make that anything you want as well. So that's the sample Anita created. And then here there's another one. So this is one of the backgrounds from Josette. The florals are the same, so those are the same flowers. These ones are from the same set, but then the leaves are from set number one. So mix and match. So that is set number four. Then we go to the strawberries, because Anita created most of these, she created all the designs, and with the help of Josette, they made it into dies. So this is the strawberry, because Anita loved the strawberries that we had before. So these are tiny, like smaller, not tiny, smaller, little flowers with it, the swirls with it, you see, and Anita created these gorgeous cards. Look at that. Look at that. And you can make different arrangements, of course. Isn't it adorable? And this is all white soft finish as well with the distress ink. Absolutely love these. Anita did a fantastic job with those. Then we go to the berry branch. So the berry branch, what I love about this one, so that one I call it with watercolor, because that's what I like. And let me show you. Of course you can use your craft drops as well, and I know I have two samples here that I use. So in this one, you see, again I cut it apart. That's what I do most of the time. That's what I did with earlier branches we had, and here I actually started cutting already, but this is one using the craft drops. But I love the watercolor, like the softer effect here as well. And I will show you some more samples where I use that beautiful branch. Then we go to the ginkgo set. And that's one of Anita's favorites as well. And she said, Els, I would love to have a ginkgo. So she designed one. And this is the set. So you have like a cluster, like a small cluster here of leaves. And then you have the three separate leaves. So this is the coloring of Anita. that you will find on the packaging. So that's beautiful with distress as well. And then I created this card using watercolors. And then the background paper, so the new Wormwood background paper. And then I watercolor those leaves using our watercolors. Absolutely loved doing that. Then we go to the elegant ornament sets. And again, this is a design from Anita. And look what she did here. It's gorgeous. You see? So I have it like upside down. And so you can kind of see, you can use it sideways as well. So this is the die set. So it's a beautiful, beautiful die set. And of course, I think you can trim it here as well. And I created this slim card here. You see? Beautiful, so the ornament, and again, so this is the berry branch here, and that is that same flower that you can see on, for instance, this card. See? So that's that one. So that's the elegant ornament set. Then we go to the pizza box. Another thing, because Anita also always has a lot of ideas, so she said, Els, I want a pizza box. And that's from some time ago, I have to say. So finally, we got a pizza box. So I need to hold it sideways, otherwise you don't see it. So this is the die set. So that's the basic die. And then it comes with the like different matting die. So a scallop, a stitched, and then circles, scalloped, a regular one, a stitched one, and a regular one. And then this piece. So that's a decorative piece as well. So you get a lot of value for money here. So that's the box. And let me show you some samples of that one. So these ones Anita created. So here you can clearly see the use of all the different elements. And then in here, you see she put that. And then you can put like, she actually had something nice, like a good idea the other day. She said, Els, like a seed bag. So if you give somebody like flower seeds, you can put the seed bags in here. How cool is that, you see? So she decorated it on the inside as well. And again, this is that flower in totally different colors. That's the same one I just showed you as well. And here she did, I think she used brush show here. See? Absolutely. And I have to say, it's so easy to put together. And this I created myself. So this can go on the card. I was just playing. And then I created these two myself. You see? So here I used a part that is actually comes with the die. And here I used, and I will get to that in a second. That's the next one. That's the last one I'm going to show you. Here you see that berry branch again. Here you see the leaves from the strawberry, and that is what I absolutely would love to see. So make the flowers in any color you want, in any shape you want. Mix and match the different leaves and the flowers together. And Joseph will show you later as well how you can make them in glitter. So that is the pizza box. And then last but not least are the stamen flower die set. So this is the set. So you got like three like these, and then the larger ones, and then the swirls and the centers here as well. But what I did with that, so this is basically what you get. But I noticed that I loved making these into flowers as well. That actually became my favorite very quickly. So that's what I used with this one. So this is basically a stack of these together. Isn't it super cool to use? And again, so here the leaves from the strawberry set. And I did some stenciling here with the stencil from Ilse and Charlene. And then this is the die that comes in the set as well. So then last but not least, the absolutely gorgeous worn wood paper. So this is a patterned cardstock, and so it's wood and it has a special layover. So you get 13 sheets. So the front sheet is number 13, but it has a print on the back. So that is one, and then the one I'm showing you, you all get two of. So it has the beautiful handwriting on here from my father-in-law, and Ilse designed it. So we had the patterns, and then Ilse made the splatters, and so she it has all those elements in there. So Ilse made it really, really special. So there's some handwriting on there. That's like a dried leaf. She did some splatters here. It's an absolutely gorgeous paper. So you can use that for your planner, your sidekick, your journal, and of course for cards. So this one, absolutely love that, like that variegation of the dark to the light. And then here she did some white splatters. There's some writing on here, so some calligraphy. And here it has some, I think it almost looks like a telephone book that she put on there. And absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous papers. So you get two of each of these. Here again, some staining there. And if you put this, like if you cut this for a card, it's so beautiful. And for pages in your Again, planner, sidekick, or your journal. Here you see the spine of the notebook that it is coming from. So here again, you see the handwriting, a little bit more vague. And then here you see something she added, like labels. And also did a fantastic job designing this paper. Love this one. I actually have that in a little box as well. So I made a pizza box out of that one already. Here, look at that. You see, absolutely gorgeous paper. Gorgeous paper. Here, look at that one. So just a splatter, so that's more plain. And here you see that same leaf, a little bit more vague. So that is the worn wood paper. I'm absolutely in love with that one. And here you see it in here a little bit like in an angle. Some splatters again. I love the colors here, like the brown, the blues, the greens going on. It's so gorgeous. And that is the last one. So this is the worn wood paper. Absolutely one of my favorites. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to check out our social media and subscribe to our YouTube channel.